In my last video, I showed you how to use the mob miniature block. That was the basics of creating models. In this video, I will show you how to use the custom model editor. It is a way more advanced way to create models. I will be breaking it up into 4 or 5 parts. If we place down the custom model editor and tap on it, this menu appears. Today, I will be showing you how to use the standard figure option. If you click on the folder button on the left side of the confirm button, it will allow you to import other models, like ones you have already created. After you click confirm, this will appear. We have the create button here, which allows you to import more units. On the right side, we have all the units that were already here. If you click on them, whichever one you clicked on will highlight. You can also click on the 3 dots on one of the units, and that will give you these options. You can modify units by importing a new one in their place. You can hide units, then you can display them again, and you can create new units, reorder levels, and delete units. We also have the increase size, decrease size, and view buttons up here in the corner. You probably noticed this menu that appears on the bottom left when a unit is selected. That allows you to edit the selected unit. These are the rotate controls. You can use the sliders or the buttons circled around the unit. Next to that, we have the scaling button. Again, you can use the slider or the button sliders beside the unit. On the opposite side, we have the location button. This allows you to move the unit anywhere. All these settings are in the model parameter section. I can't click on the bone parameter yet because I am in model, not animation, as you can see in the top middle. Now I'm going to go to the animation section. In the bottom left, it has switched to bone parameter. Up underneath the model animation buttons, we have all the basic animations. The button beside it allows you to edit the actions. Now I can't click on model parameter because I'm in animation. In bone parameter, you can only edit the rotations, not the scale or location. If you click on the button that says 30 frame, you can change how many frames you want in your animation. The green plus button allows you to add keyframes. You can also click on keyframes and have these extra functions. All you have to do to animate is to create a starting pose on the first keyframe, make another keyframe, and create your next pose. The closer your keyframes are to each other, the faster the animation will be. You can move around keyframes by using the 2 arrow buttons. The button to the right of those arrows allows you to toggle the animation loop. If it is off, the animation will not loop. If it is on, it will loop. You also have the play/pause button. The buttons beside the play/pause button allow you to move from frame to frame. The red button allows you to copy-paste and delete keyframes. If you click on the check mark in the upper left corner, you get the option to give your model a name and description. You can also generate it as a block, prop, or creature. Save action combination, when on, saves your model so you can import and edit it. I will be generating as a creature. Here I have the creature in my inventory. I can place however many I want. They also perform the animation I gave them. And remember, I will be creating a few more parts after this.